Yo, what's up guys? It's Raddy here in the gym. I want to give you a quick way to improve feeling in your muscles, because when you're lifting weights, if you're not feeling your muscles, you're probably putting that weight into your joints and not doing yourself any favors. Or if you're like me, you know, in the past I wasn't able to feel my chest, so I do exercises for my chest, but no soreness, no growth, because I couldn't feel my chest during the workouts. So important is the feeling of the chest. So how do you get feeling when you have difficulty feeling? So one, try super isolating things. For me, what helped with my chest and getting the feeling was actually a squeeze press. So here, you just take something. This is chest specific, but can be done with anything. Take something, squeeze it out, and I'm just trying to basically squeeze through it, basically activating my chest. And I'm holding that position, moving it around gently, and trying to see where I can actually feel what's happening in my chest with my mind. So you gotta isolate, slow things down, break down movements based on the muscle patterns. So chest specifically, arms will go forwards and adduct. That's what the chest will do for you. And basically I just broke it down and tried to stimulate that position. So instead of trying to load up a weight like a barbell and trying to feel it during the exercise, pre-fatigue the chest, try and get the neural connections going in there so that you can feel it and then take it to an exercise. And what you do with the exercise or with this is close your eyes. If you close your eyes, your brain's basically not having to process all this visual signal and junk, and that lets it tune inwards. And the more you can tune inwards, the easier it is to start feeling whatever muscle you want to feel. So if your form is off or you're not feeling a muscle, make it light. Try not to, you know, have some sort of balance component. If you're doing a lunge, it's gonna be hard to not fall over. So like, you know, grab a pole or something. If you're on a bench and you're just flat backed, close your eyes, squeeze that bar, trying to imitate the movement you did that helped you stimulate the muscle, and slowly bring it in, trying to get that engagement without worrying about the weight. You wanna use the lightest possible weight to get the most stimulus, as opposed to the most amount of weight, and just move it to show off. You're training for strength and power, you're not demonstrating it, okay? The demonstrations are far and few in between. Don't go into the workout thinking, okay, I'm gonna demonstrate this linear progression to myself or to my peers. You know, last week I did 135, now I'm gonna do 445, now 155. Linear progression is very, very challenging. The body does what it wants to do. So you gotta, you know, feel what's happening inside you if something's hurting. Slightly off topic. Anyways, if you wanna improve feeling in the muscle that you're trying to target, close your eyes. Yeah, it's as simple as that. Pre-fatigue, try a little, you know, isolations to get the muscle feeling. Go to the exercise, close your eyes, and focus in. Literally put your mind on the muscle you're trying to work. If you have a partner, they can also just like touch you a little bit. The stimulation up here helps to bring more attention to the mind. And you can also do it with yourself too. Like if I'm pushing a single arm, I'll touch my pec and I'll see like, you know, is it actually hard? Is it actually engaging? Is it working? And I'll slow down the movement. Who cares about the reps? Don't worry about the reps. And I'll adjust my position just a little bit so I can get that actual squeeze. Because sometimes I'll go to push and it's like, oh, this is soft. Okay, let me get the activation, because if it's soft, it's not really working. Same thing for glutes, for quads, hamstrings, abs, back. If it's not hard and tight, like it's not being contracted, it's not being squeezed. So you gotta work on the muscle connections. Also, another thing is don't do too many exercises. If you have 10 different chest exercises, you don't really get good at one exercise and you don't build the skill of it and the feel. Better to stick with less exercises and develop the skill and the muscle connection so that when you do that one exercise, you actually feel what's happening and get something out of it. Because sometimes I'll do flies and I don't really feel the effect, versus if I do a bench or a push-up or something that I'm actually more versed in, more skilled in. I haven't spent a lot of time doing flies, so I don't have that same connection. Even though it's the muscle of the pecs and I feel like my pecs are a lot better now, I don't have that connection. So exercise selection too is another one. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Make sure to stay tuned for the others, and I'll see you in the next one.